let's go to a graphic we have for some of those risk factors that can cause SIDS. And Dr. Fernandez, if you can talk to us a little bit about these. We touched upon a few, but let's go more into depth about how these contribute as well.
Absolutely. So in terms of sex, we know that male infants, boy babies, have a significantly higher propensity to experience SIDS. We spoke about the age. We said that by definition, SIDS occurs in the first year of life, with the highest peak between 2 to 4 months of age. In terms of race, sadly, African American babies are 2.5 times more likely to suffer from SIDS. Family history. This is very sad, because we know that families that have perhaps a lower socioeconomic level, a lower education, history of domestic violence, maybe substance abuse issues, alcohol issues, all these cofactors contribute to a higher incidence of SIDS. And there is some research out there that says that families that have suffered the tragedy of having a baby lost to SIDS have a higher incidence of it happening again. Paula spoke about secondhand smoke, but I'd like to add to that also we found that mothers who smoke during their pregnancy, those babies also have a higher incidence of suffering SIDS. And of course, prematurity, the younger the baby was born, the higher the incidence of suffering SIDS.